Hello everyone. I hope you all fine. We are going forward with worksheet 11. Worksheet 11, we have a couple of questions which are really important, as well. Some questions are already presented in the previous year question papers. So I hope you will have a good explanation. Well, yes, going forward with the first question. When a person listens and attempts to understand the other person's viewpoint, it can be termed as what? Active listening, empathetic listening, critical listening, and none of the above. It is an empathetic listen. Empathetic listening is a process when a person listens and attempts to understand other person's viewpoint. So it can be also dealt as an empathetic listening, right? Yes. So yeah, we have a second question. Which gender tends to listen in order to solve the problems is less attentive to non-verbal cues and interruptive speech topics? Yes. Man is a gender. So who listens in order to solve the problems well? He will solve the problems in the less attentive to the normal cues and interruptive speech topics. Generally, if that is a female or a woman, they will not listen properly. They will just react instead of responding. Whereas in the case of man, the listening aspect will be the more, right? Men. So option A is the correct answer. Critical thinking. What is the critical thinking? It focuses solely on the details instead of the main point. Ignores that context in which communication is occurring. Is more important when making judgments about message being presented. Is only associated with the linguistic. Critical thinking is important when making judgments about the message being presented, right? It is really important when making judgments. So, asking questions to clarify the information, paraphrasing messages, and identifying the confusing areas are basically barriers to the listening. Listening for the fun, techniques for checking your understanding of the message, or none of the above. It is techniques for checking your understanding. Asking questions to clarify the information, paraphrasing the message and identifying the confusion areas are basically techniques for checking your understanding, right? Option C is the correct answer. So fourth question, fifth question, we have suggestions for lecture listening includes. Suggestions for lecture listening includes focusing on the delivery part and avoiding summarizing and reviewing the information, poor attention in order to think creatively, not to making notes as to focus better on lecture and message delivery, finding the areas of interest to you, avoiding distractions and listening for the main ideas. Yes, finding the areas of interest to you, avoiding the distractions and listening to the main ideas is a suggestion for the lecture listening. Yes. Option C, question number 6. The ability to locate, evaluate and effectively use the information is an important trait known as selective attention. Selective attention is a trait, or it is in a technique, or it is an ability to locate, evaluate and effectively use information, right? Yes. At primary level, it is better to teach the mother language because why? Why it is really important at the primary level, why it is better to teach in the mother language? Because it helps the children to learn in the natural atmosphere.
Learning in natural atmosphere is really important for the child. So, in order to learn in the natural atmosphere, it is generally preferred to teach in the mother language. Yes? The best approach to motivate the students is by guiding them suitable prizes, providing them proper guidance, giving examples all the time, delivering speeches. The best approach to motivate students is providing them the proper guidance. Providing them proper guidance itself is a motivation to the students, right? Yeah. The best way a teacher can try to inculcate good values among the students is how the storytelling, the best way a teacher can try to inculcate good values among students is by developing a sense of discipline, ideal behavior of teachers themselves to take their parents into confidence. Yeah, ideal behavior of teachers themselves shows good values, it inculcates the good values in the students. If the teacher behavior is not appropriate or it is not up to the mark, then students may not take in good values from the teacher. So, in order to inculcate a good values among the students, first of all, the teacher should be possessing of good behavior, right? Yes. So teacher should inculcate the good values so that students
may be getting the inculcated by the good values. Yes? How the student should be motivated to get success in the life? Circuit study, incidental study, intense study, rote learning. Yes, intensive study will really help the students to get motivated to success in their life. Intensive study is with some kind of targets, moving according to the targets, whatever it might be. Yes. The problem of an absenteeism can be tackled by how? Yes. Reduction of the weight of a curriculum, sympathy of the teachers, attractive environment of the school, and the motivation of the students. It is purely motivation of the students. It is a purely motivation of students towards the students itself will reduce the absenteeism, right? Yes. The best remedy of a student's problem related with learning is what? Suggestion for the hard work, supervise the study in the library, suggestions for private tuitions, diagnostic teaching. So best remedy of a student's problems related with the learning is diagnostic teaching. Diagnostic teaching, right? Yes. Emotional adjustments of students is effective in what? Personality formation, class teaching, discipline, all the above. So yes, in the personality formation, the class teaching, discipline, emotional adjustment of students is really, it should be really effective. So if the emotional adjustment is really effective, then only the class will move in the appropriate ways and there will be some kind of discipline arises. Effective class teaching goes out and personality formation will be happy. Who among the following is described as father of psychoanalysis? So psychoanalysis, it is in Sigmund Freud. Sigmund Freud is being considered as what is called as father of psychoanalysis. Yes. So going forward with the main proponent of the cognitive theory of teaching is N.L. Gagey. N.L. Gagey is a main proponent of cognitive theory or the teaching, right? Practical knowledge of languages learned at school, language laboratory, language teaching and language instructions. Practical knowledge of language will be learned at the language laboratory rather than not in the school, not in the language teaching, language instructions. Language laboratory is a place where effective knowledge of language will be possessed or will be taught. Are you understanding? So, language laboratory is a platform where the language information will be clearly possessed. All the information regarding to the learning of language skills will be clearly evaluated. Right? In which domain does the following objective fall? At the end of the lesson, the learner should be able to hit the football using the head. At the end of the lesson, the learner should be able to hit the football using the head, not using the foot. So automatically the problem should not arise. So it is like psychomotor domain. Psychomotor domain is a domain which deals with the acquiring of skills, isn't it? Acquiring of technical skills. So after acquiring the technical skills, then there should not be any position for a learner to face a problems. So at the end of the day, the learner should be able to hit the football using the head. It is psychomotor domain. Yes. Psychomotor domain. Yes. Are you understanding? Yes. Planning or arranging the student's environment in order to predict the consequences of student's behavior is referred to. It is a stimulus control, we can say. It is not prompting or it is not reinforcement or it is not shaping. So it is all about that stimulus control, which is stimulus control. It is in process of planning or arranging the student's environment in order to predict the consequences of the student's behavior. So what is going to be happen? How this child behavior or the student's behavior is going to get influenced in the future? So all these things should be getting analyzed. You know that happens only through the stimulus control itself, right? Yes. Which theory of learning has found that knowledge of internal processes is crucial to understanding the learning? So, cognitive theory is the theory of learning that has found that knowledge of internal processes is crucial to the understanding of learning. Internal process learning is not good, then automatically the understanding of learning do not happen, right? This is cognitive theory. Which aspect of evaluation is used when the teacher ensures that student complete an exercise in the mathematics and also make sure that instructions are clear and specific? It is in validity. So validity, practicality, reliability and consistency. So validity is really thing which is required, or it is an evaluation is used when the teacher ensures that students complete an exercise in mathematics and also make sure that instructions are clear and specific. Yes, it is a principle of validity. Yes, principle of validity. When which of the following is not a characteristic of a slow learner? So, characteristic of a slow learner, it is like a limited vocabulary, short span of attention, abstract thinking, limited range of interest. It is an abstract thinking. So limited vocabulary, obviously, you know, slow learner will be having a limited vocabulary. He may not be getting pickup in the regard of vocabulary. Short span of attention, because attention in the time, in the regard of an attention, he might have a short span. Limited range of interest, a slow learner may have, he may not have getting knowledge or upgraded. So, abstract thinking is not the factor or characteristic of a slow learner. Why? Abstract thinking always speaks about purpose, process and output. Abstract thinking, what does it mean? Abstract thinking speaks about the purpose of study, the process of study and what is the output of the study. So, generally this kind of thinking may not happen with regards to, or in the case of, it does not happen in the case of slow learner. Right? Abstract thinking is the factor which or characteristic which is not in the slow learner. I hope you understood, right? Yeah. The teacher used the following statement to change the behavior of the students who was a smoker. Smoking is unhealthy for the nation. Smoking is unhealthy often. Unhealthy for the nation. So this is an example of cognitive dissonance. Yes, it is in cognitive dissonance. Yes. Yeah. 1 minute. Yes, the cognitive dissonance should be used by the teacher to change the behavior of student who was really smoking. So, cognitive dissonance will really help to think. The learner should think what exactly the statement has been passed by the teacher or the lecturer, right? So that automatically there is some chance of getting a change in the behavior of student behavior, right? Yes. So, the best way to memorize is called as, what is the best way to memorize? Study for the long time, no, to understand the concept, to read loudly, to write the concept, to understand the concept. First of all, until and unless you get understand the concept, until and unless you get understand of the concept, you cannot memorize. In order to memorize for the long time, the understanding should happen. Until and unless the understanding happens, you cannot go for the memorization. Yes? Yeah. Attitudes, concepts, skills and knowledge are the products of what? Attitudes, concepts, skills and the knowledge are the products of learning, research, heredity, explanation. It is learning. Yes, attitudes, concepts, skills and the knowledge are the product of learning. Learning should be happen. Yes? Yeah. Which of the following is not a product of learning? Attitudes. Yes, attitudes. Yes. Learning, attitudes depends upon the learning. Attitude depends upon the learning. Concepts, concepts. Yes, it's knowledge. Yes, of course, knowledge. Learning, knowledge depends upon the learning. Concepts depends on the learning. Attitudes depends upon the learning. But maturation doesn't focus or doesn't depend on the learning. Maturation is something coming by grow by the mental stress or mental attitudes. Maturation is a point coming out of the mental attitudes. It's not through the learning, right? So we have a last question. It is like 26th question. Wait a minute, just I'm just making you some clear points. Kindly share our videos to your friends. You will be getting all the MCQs from the KVS Madam book for free. So subscribe the channel and press on the bell icon for the more updates. I hope you clearly understood. You subscribe the video and share our videos. So if you have any queries, feel free to post on the comment section or you can write us to purnaeducare@gmail.com. So kindly subscribe and click on the bell icon for the more advertising of the videos to your friends. So you will be getting all the MCQs from the KVS Madam book, right? So going forward with the some students in the class exhibit great curiosity for the learning. It may be because such children are gifted. Yes. So only if they are gifted, then automatically they will exhibit the great curiosity of learning. Thank you so much. Jai Hind.